All right, so indicators again are inflation, unemployment. Let's see what else we have. You may have what's called a recession. Recession simply means the economy going down, the economy shrinking, okay? The economy is going bad, people losing jobs. Recession is associated with higher unemployment, people losing jobs, people can't find jobs, falling wages, falling salaries, falling rent price. But the big one in recession is here, falling profit. If you're running a business, businesses are more likely profits to go down or to lose money. So the opposite of profit is called a loss. Loss. Okay. If you have a recession, you have a special type of unemployment called cyclical unemployment. Okay, cyclical unemployment depends on or is related with the business cycle. And the business cycle is simply the economy going up, we call it a boom time, and the economy going down called recession. Okay? So the economy goes up and down, up and down, up and down. Okay? So when the economy goes up, cyclical unemployment goes down. When the economy goes down, cyclical unemployment increases. Yes. Let's see. So, I said recession. Now, recession could turn out to be bad. Very bad. Really bad. And for a long time. So, it's got a special name called depression. Depression. The economy is so depressed and going down that people feel depressed. They don't feel good, okay? They feel bad. They don't see good prospects. They don't hope to find a job. So depression is associated with a very bad economy, which affects people thinking, hopes, expectations. They don't feel good about life in general. Let's see what else we have. Okay. You have now economic policy. And economic policy is what the government does to affect the economy. So the government can do a number of things to affect the economy. Number one, which is very important here in the GCC, but also in the US and most Western countries, called fiscal policy. Fiscal policy. Fiscal policy is government spending. How much government spends. Fiscal policy is associated with two things. Number one is government. Now, government spending has a, in economics, a special word called government expenditure. Expenditure is the same as spending. Government expenditure.
This is the amount of money which the government spends on schools, hospitals, roads, army, whatever the government spends on. And the second part is government revenue. As in government taxation, which should be very familiar here at home, where the government on what was date introduced a VAT tax. Was it in January
1?
5%. 5%, but when? January 1, 2018, for the first time introduced 5% value added tax. Tax. Up to this point, there were no taxes here, okay? So this is the first tax here. So that's a government policy. Government taxation means prices will go up a little bit for everyone, okay? And it will mean a little bit that the standard of living will fall with the price increase. Now, if the government says tax at 5%, maybe prices will go 3% up, maybe 4, maybe they'll just go 5% up. So, if prices go up 5%, your salary will buy 5% less goods and services. And the standard of living will fall with the tax. Okay, so the tax is 5%, the standard of living on average will fall by 5%. Of course, some salaries will come up 5% to compensate for the tax. Okay? So that's fiscal policy. So fiscal policy has these two. The other one is called monetary policy. And monetary policy is the quantity of money in circulation. How much money the government prints, or how much the money supply increases. So monetary policy has two elements. The one is money supply. So if the government prints more money and spends more money, this is usually results in stronger economy until prices go up, okay? So this has a short-term stimulus effect. Same thing with fiscal policy. If the government spends more, it has a short-term effect, maybe 3 months, maybe 1 year, maybe 2 years. As prices go up, the effect slowly disappears. And the other one is interest rates. Interest rates. And interest rate is the price of money. Is how much you pay to borrow money. So if you borrow let's say 20,000 and have to return 20,500. 500 is your interest. And the rate is simply interest measured in percentages. So interest is the extra amount of money that you pay to back for a loan. Interest rate is the percentage. So the interest is 500. The interest rate may be 1% or 2%. Okay? You want a simple example? Okay, simple example. You borrow 50,000 and they say that you will have to pay 50,500. Okay? So the interest is 500. The interest rate is 500 divided by 50,000 is 1%. But now the question is, you're going to pay 50,500 what? After 1 month, or after 2 months, or after 1 year?
If you pay after 1 year, you say that it's 1% per year. If you have to pay 500 interest after 1 month, you say it's 1% per month, which will translate to 12-13% per year. Okay, so this is just a percentage, is an easy number because it measures it up to the initial amount. It's called principal. Let's see what else we have. So the government can control interest rate. If interest rate is less, businesses will borrow more to invest. Okay, so interests are low, it's cheap to borrow, so you borrow and you buy something, okay? You invest. If you're a consumer, where is that thing here? Here. Okay, if you're a consumer, let me write it out for you, okay? So, if interest rates go down, arrow down means go down, okay? This means two things. Investments will increase. It's a lot cheaper to borrow if you're a business, so you will borrow to invest more. But also, usually, consumption goes up. If interest rate is 1 or 2%, you can borrow money to buy a new car. You can borrow money to buy whatever, a computer. You can borrow money to buy a house, okay? So, consumer borrowing increases and consumer spending increases. And business borrowing increases and investment increases. And this overall has a positive effect on the economy. And the last thing, okay, it's not in the book. There's one other, it's not in the book. Let's just say regulatory policy. These are government regulations. The government may require this or may require that, may require stamps, may require labels, may require certifications, whatever the government regulates. Of course, governments regulate everywhere in the world, including here, banks. Banks are heavily regulated, okay? Well, can you just drive any car anywhere? No, there are regulations about cars, about registrations, okay? You want to open a business? Sometimes you may have to register the business. Okay, you want to guys sell guns and machine guns? Not allowed. Well, it means you will have to have a very special permit from the government. Okay. Of course, regulatory means you want to open pharmacy. You need special license and registration from the government, okay? You can't just open a pharmacy like that, okay? All right, you want to sell prescription medicine? Again, not really. Time to go? Yes? Okay. And last piece, one last piece. Stabilization policy. It's very simple. If the economy goes too fast, too quick, meaning growth is very high, the government will raise a little bit of interest rate and lower government expenditures to slow the economy. For example, government will want to have the economy growing at 4% is very good. If the economy grows 7, 8, 10%, that's too much, too fast. Very fast growth causes too many problems and chaos. So the government will want to slow down the economy. On the other hand, if the economy is slow, sluggish, or in recession, or just 1%, not enough, the government will stimulate the economy. It will have more government expenditure, okay? It will increase spending to stimulate the economy. It will lower interest rates to stimulate the economy. So, if the economy is going too fast, the government will try to slow a little bit down. If the economy is too slow, it's going to try to accelerate it close to its target, close to its optimum. Most governments believe that 4-5% is very good, is optimal. Okay, more than 5 is too much, and too many problems occur. Example: extremely fast growth in Dubai, which you all consider is good. The negative effect is traffic jams. You know, you try to go, I try to come back on 6:11, and it's not moving, slow. Okay, so you get traffic jams. Too much growth can mean other simple things like too many cars. Everyone's buying a car, everyone's driving a car. You can't park your car. Okay, you can't find parking. Okay, so these are little things, but there are other bigger things. The economy is going too fast. So fast, demand is so high, the rents get extremely high. 100,000 a year, that's very high, right? Well, suddenly people can't anymore pay the rent. They gotta live outside Dubai and drive. And traffic's already bad and it gets worse, okay? So these are simple examples of very fast growing economy can have very high inflation, okay? So it may cause a whole bunch of other problems. So you don't want to grow too fast, but you don't want to grow too slow. A good growth is 3-5%. All right, is this good enough for today? All right, okay. So I'll see you next time, and chapter 2. This completes chapter 1.